Man is a trinity. You are a trinity. I am a trinity. Consisting of body, soul, and spirit. The body is separate from the soul. The soul is separate from the body. The spirit is not the soul, neither is the soul the body. I know that when one speaks of the Trinity, it's very hard for the average person to understand, and yet, perhaps it's because it has never been explained to them. In reality, it's very simple. Very simple. Simple to understand. The Bible has made it very understandable to one. I gave an illustration that perhaps will help you too in causing you to understand the difference between the soul, the body, and the spirit. I likened the Trinity of man to a peach. The Trinity of a peach. For a peach is also a trinity. Consider with me for just a minute. There is the flesh of the peach, that part of the peach which we eat. Oftentimes, whenever we think of a peach, we only think of it in the light of that part which we eat. That which we eat is the flesh of that peach. But there is also the stone of the peach. But that's not all. There's also the kernel of the peach. And there we have the Trinity of the peach. The flesh, the stone, the kernel. Now watch something for just a minute. What the flesh is to the peach, so is the body to man. The human body of man is the exact place what the flesh is to the peach. You have a human body. I have a human body. But remember something. Inside of this flesh, there is a soul. What the stone is to the peach, so is the soul to man. One is separate and apart from the other. You understand that there you have the Trinity of man. There's body, soul, and spirit in exactly the same way as you have the Trinity of the peach. The flesh, the peach, the stone, the kernel. You remove the flesh of the peach, and the kernel still has a body. And what is that body? The stone. Now then, this soulish body of man can hear, can speak, can remember. Therefore, it must have a tangible form, just as I am as much myself when I'm stripped of my clothing as when I have my clothing on. In other words, I will be me forever and ever and ever. The soul never sleeps. Your soul, my soul, will never sleep. The only difference, when death comes, and the soul and the spirit depart from the body, that spirit goes to be in the presence of the Lord. No, beloved. There is no such thing as soul sleep. The soul does not sleep. The spirit does not sleep. In that open grave is just the body, the flesh. You can never place me, not really me. That part of me that is eternal. That part of me that only God knows. That soul, that spirit of me, can never and will never be placed in the earth. No grave can hold it. No grave will ever contain it. It will never be buried. Death cannot touch it. Fire cannot destroy it. But my body, the flesh, one third of me, is placed in that grave, awaiting that glorious resurrection morning. And beloved, that day is coming when that one third of me that is placed in the earth will again be reunited with the two-thirds of me that have been waiting in the presence of Jesus.